But as we hit another grim milestone in this pandemic, and as so many of our lives remain upended, we take a look now at how these uncertain times are impacting our children. Experts say the virus, plus the isolation of virtual learning and social distancing from their friends, all create a recipe for anxiety and depression. ABC's Ariel Reshef has this report.
Mad.
Mad. Why do you feel mad, Buglet?
Because of this pandemic thing.
They're feelings so many kids are experiencing during these highly unusual times. 9-year-old Anderson Fields, one of an estimated 4.4 million children nationwide coping with anxiety amid the COVID-19 pandemic, and 1.9 million dealing with depression.
I want my kids to be okay.
Disruptions to daily life, school by screen, mask mandates, throwing off routines and throwing families for a loop. The youngest generation navigating the isolation and uncertainty of this new normal. Childhood anxiety already on the rise prior to the pandemic. According to recent studies, there has been a 17% jump in anxiety diagnoses in children 17 and younger over the past 10 years. And Dr. Dave Anderson of the Child Mind Institute says the current crisis is accelerating this trend.
So the research that we do have available during the pandemic indicates, you know, stark increases across the entire population in anxiety and depression symptoms.
New Jersey mom Nashae Clark says she's seeing a clear impact on her 13-year-old daughter Taylor and her 9-year-old son Anderson, her youngest still struggling like so many others to adjust to all of this change.
My kid definitely needs structure, a lot of structure. And it's hard to create structure and work and get him through online school and manage his emotions and manage my emotions. It's just tough. And he's 9 years old. And how is he supposed to process all of this?
Nashae says she noticed a shift in her son's behavior as the pandemic dragged on.
What are some of the different behavioral patterns that you're seeing in Anderson that you didn't see before?
He's definitely more anxious. We've had a couple situations where even during just kind of the normal routine of the day, or once we were, with some friends socially distanced at, you know, a little backyard gathering, and he just kind of froze. And he said a scary thought went through his head. And, you know, I went to hug him and his heart was beating out of his chest. And I had to hold him for a little while. And he said, you know, the world's really scary right now.
And the Clarks are not alone. Nashae is part of a network of families supporting one another, their kids sharing a similar experience. Her friend, New Jersey mom Cynthia Verhov, says social distancing only enhances the anxiety her 6-year-old daughter Maddie naturally feels.
So my youngest in particular has had a challenging time adjusting to all of these changes. And some of the things that would normally put a kid that's more anxious at ease, you can't do. They can't really kind of play around with their friends or have their mom or dad stand next to them and walk them in. So it kind of sets the tone for just really kind of a buildup, right, of anxiety. And so you kind of have that element. And then when they get into the classroom, they're 6 feet apart and they're really tethered to their desks, which, you know, for young kids is highly unusual. It's not what a typical first grade classroom would look like.
Dr. Anderson says he's seeing more kids suffering from varying degrees of depression and anxiety.
You know, I think early on in the pandemic, we saw kids who were very, very worried about their parents getting sick. So little was known kind of at the outset about transmission and how that was happening, that we saw kids who were very worried about, you know, packages passing even within a few feet of people, even when they were outside. What we're seeing now is an increase in that anxiety as schools begin to reopen.
And experts say, especially now, it's critical to watch your children carefully for signs of emotional distress, even if they've never exhibited them before.
What you can watch first is body language, which is that if a kid is you know, about to confront a situation they may be anxious about, they're going to appear kind of inhibited. They're going to appear shy. They're going to be trying to avoid that particular thing. Some kids may even act out in advance of situations that they're anxious about, where they yell or they tantrum or they try to avoid it as much as they possibly can. Our repeated question asking, so a kid is looking for repeated reassurance, asking the same question over and over, are you sure we're going to be safe when we do this? Are you sure that grandpa's okay? You know, those sorts of things. For kids who are anxious, we might see them have difficulty falling asleep just because they're anxious about what might happen that next day, or they're thinking about lots of different things.
And with millions of kids in the U.S. learning from home, experts say virtual schooling can exacerbate the psychological toll.
Kids will tell us they're worried that they're not able to maintain their focus as easily, where they get a lot more burned out by spending more time on virtual learning, or they're worried that they really can't seem to kind of follow the class because it just isn't the same format that they're used to or way of presenting material.
But while online schooling isn't perfect, Dr. Anderson says it is essential for kids to maintain a connection. And as for some concrete ways to ease your child's anxiety,
so what we focus on in therapy is exposing kids in very small doses to the things that they're afraid of. And for kids who don't have clinically relevant anxiety, you can do the same thing at home. If you're trying to help your kid confront their fears, what really helps after the fact is to remind them that it wasn't as bad as they thought.
Essential tools to help kids cope and families find their way through this extraordinary time. Ariel Reshef, ABC News, New York.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.